In this video, let's see how you can strengthen or boost your immune system during this COVID-19 pandemic. You know, they say exercise is king, nutrition is queen. Put them together and you've got a strong kingdom. But the army of that kingdom is your immunity. While you really can't boost your immunity beyond its natural limits, you definitely can optimize it to work at maximum efficiency. I'm going to divide this very important topic into two videos. This one is an overview of the basics, the science, and the hard work that you have to put in. The second video will be all about the superfoods, the vitamins, the minerals, the supplements, and DIY or do-it-yourself stuff with recipes. So let's get going. Hi. I'm Dr. Manoj Bharucha, and on this channel, I discuss various current topics to keep you well informed by cutting through the clutter, simplifying the science, and silencing the fakes. If you're new here, do consider subscribing and hit the like button if you find value in this video. Guess what? The best immunity booster for COVID-19 is out, and it's the vaccine. Be sensible. Don't fall prey to conspiracy theories and fear-mongering on social media. And please take the vaccine as soon as you can. I've taken my first dose and I did have some fever and body ache for a day or so. But that tells me that my body is producing antibodies and boosting my immunity to the virus. I'm also protecting so many others while doing so. On the whole, your immune system does a remarkable job of defending you against many bacteria and viruses. But sometimes it fails. A germ invades and makes you sick. Is it possible to intervene in this process and boost your immune system? What if you improve your diet? What if you take certain vitamins, herbal preparations, or make other lifestyle changes in the hope of producing a near perfect immune response? The immune system is precisely that, a system. It's not a single entity. To function well, it requires balance and harmony. There is still much that researchers do not know about the immune response or the immune system. In the meantime, specific healthy living strategies are a good way to start. Your immune system can defeat invading pathogens only when the germs are no match for the large phagocytes or the white blood cells, which swallow and kill the germs. Your first line of defense is to choose a healthy lifestyle. Every part of your body, including your immune system, functions better when protected from an unhealthy lifestyle and pollution, both in the air and in your food. You are what you eat, what you breathe, and what you think. So, don't smoke. Eat a diet high in fruits and vegetables. Exercise regularly. A weight training and cardio combo seems to be the best for this. Maintain a healthy weight. Drink alcohol in moderation, only if you must. Get adequate sleep. 6 to 8 hours is what is recommended. Take steps to avoid infection, such as washing your hands frequently with soap and water or a sanitizer. Try to minimize stress. I know it's difficult to do that, but try. Immunity and age. As we age, our immune response reduces, which in turn contributes to more severe infections. The elderly are much more likely to contract infectious diseases and more likely to die from them. Influenza, COVID-19, and pneumonias are a leading cause of death in people over 65 years of age. A reduction in immune response to infections has been demonstrated by older people's response to vaccines. For example, studies of influenza vaccines like flu shots have shown that for people over the age of 65, the vaccine is less effective compared to young, healthy adults. But it's still immensely important because it reduces the severity of infection and the death rate in older people. Diet and your immune system. The immune system army marches on its stomach. A healthy immune system warrior or warriors need good regular nourishment. Various deficiencies, for example, deficiencies of vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin D, and trace elements like zinc, iron, and folic acid will decrease your immune response. So, what can you do? If you suspect your diet is not providing you with all the nutrients, like for instance, you don't like vegetables, then taking a daily multivitamin and mineral supplement can help. taking mega doses doesn't do anything extra and can be toxic. So more is not necessarily better. Can you boost your immunity with herbs and supplements? Walk into any pharmacy and you will find shelves full of pills and herbal preparations which claim to boost your immune system and boost your immune response. By far, this is only advertising, exaggerated to increase their sales. Most of these herbal supplements are actually harmful to the liver and can even cause blood thinning. So be careful. I'll discuss this in greater detail in the next video. Stress and the immune function. Modern medicine has come to appreciate the closely linked relationship of the mind and the body. A wide variety of illnesses related to lowered immunity, including tummy upsets, skin rashes, and even heart disease, are linked to the effects of emotional stress. Prolonged or continuing stress is terrible for the immune system, while short-term stress isn't as harmful. Exercise, good or bad? Regular exercise is one of the pillars of healthy living. It improves cardiovascular health. It lowers your blood pressure. It helps you lose fat and gain muscle, which in turn protects against a variety of diseases. It helps you boost your immune system naturally and keep it healthy. It also improves your blood circulation, which allows the immune army to move through the body freely and do their job efficiently. So what are you doing to help yourself? I'd like to know what you are doing to boost your immunity. Do you have a secret formula for your good health? Have you had COVID? Will you take the vaccine? Let me know in the comments below. If you found value in this video, please give it a like. Watch part 2 for the shortcuts to give you and to give your immunity that extra boost. I'm Dr. Manoj Bharucha signing out. Thank you for your time.